A very good afternoon and welcome to the 10th edition of Realty Plus Conclave and Excellence Awards South for 2018. Before we start with the day's proceedings, I'd like to share with you a little bit about Realty Plus magazine from the Exchange 4 Media Group. Now, Realty Plus was started in 2004 and is one of the oldest and most respected real estate publications in the country. In 2009, at the height of the real estate recession in India, the first Realty Plus conclave was held to foster a dialogue between key building industry stakeholders. The Realty Plus conclave of 2009 is often cited as one of the crucial developments that marked the comeback of real estate during that period. Since then, the Realty Plus conclaves have become the highlight events of the real estate sector in India. The 10th edition of Realty Plus Conclave 2018, held today, promises to carry this agenda forward with a conference that will showcase presentations and panel discussions featuring speakers from varied segments of the realty industry, as well as special addresses by some eminent personalities. So a lot to look forward to this afternoon. The highlights of our evening are the Realty Plus Converse fireside session of the Architects Panel and the very first Realty Plus PropTech Summit that deliberates on the current hot topic of technology in real estate. So a couple of firsts that's happening this year to kind of celebrate our 10th year, you know, existence in this industry. So something really to look forward for all of you lovely people. So friends, without any further delay, let's begin the event with the inaugural lighting of the lamp and the Ganesh mantra. And I'd like to request the following to please head over to the lamp as I call their names. Please put your hands together for Tripti Kedia, publisher, Realty Plus. I'd like to invite Mr. Amit Vadhwani, founder, Sai Estate Property Consultants. Please put your hands together for Mr. Joe Verghese, Managing Director, India Colliers International. Please put your hands together for Mr. Farooq Mahmood, President, FIA BCI International. A louder round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. Coming up is Mr. Srinivasan Subramanian, CEO, SNN Builders Private Limited. Please put your hands together for Ramani Sastri, CMD Sterling Developers. Put your hands together for Mr. Balakrishna Hegde, Managing Director, Chartered Housing. Put your hands together for Mr. Pankaj Kapoor, Founder and Managing Director, Lysis Forest. And last but not the least, Architect, Mr. Shekhar James, Principal Architect and Managing Director, Masterplan Landscapes Architect. A huge round of applause, ladies and gentlemen, as our dignitaries light the traditional lamp. And can we also have the Ganesh mantra? Right, a huge round of applause. The lighting of the lamp is just done. Thank you. Thank you so much. You may all please take your seats. Now that the Almighty has blessed us. All right. Now, as Dr. Annurag Batra, our chairman and editor-in-chief, Business World and Exchange for Media, could not join us this afternoon, he has sent a very brief welcome address for all of you. So I'd like the console to please play the AV, please.
Good evening. Welcome to the South Indian edition of the Realty Plus Conclave and Awards. This is the 10th year of the Realty Plus Conclave and Awards South. Our publisher, Tripti Kedia, and our editor, Sapna Shivastava, put this initiative together. Reality Plus is the only national real estate magazine platform. It's the only national real estate editorial platform. We have a website, magazine, events that bring stakeholders face to face, and we're truly national in the way we engage with all the stakeholders in the real estate ecosystem. South is especially special for Realty Plus because Bangalore is one of those real estate markets that hasn't seen the downturn like the market in NCR or elsewhere in the country. The buoyant demand of e-commerce companies, ITS companies, IT companies has made sure that the commercial space, co-working spaces, the residences, everything is doing much better than as compared to elsewhere in the country. So really, Realty Plus salutes these leaders from Southern India who made sure that the real estate sector is more dynamic than anywhere else. Realty Plus now has a show on Republic that my friend Amit Wadhwani and me host on Republic TV. So I wish all the participants, speakers, a great day of learnings and interactions, and I wish all the winners all the best. We are a jury-led awards, we are a process-led awards, and the awards have high integrity. So thank you. I couldn't be there in person, but I welcome all of you to this great Realty Plus event, and at some stage look forward to interacting with you. Thank you. God bless you.
Well, that's Dr. Annurag Batra for you. Quite a dynamic man if you've met him. Great. All right. And now I'd like to request Ms. Sapna Srivastava, editor Realty Plus, to please deliver the welcome speech. Could we have a round of applause, ladies and gentlemen, for Ms. Sapna Srivastava? Good afternoon, everyone, and a very warm welcome to all of you on behalf of the entire Realty Plus team. In fact, first of all, I would like to thank you all for being here, being part of the conclave today. A special thanks to all of the speakers who have come from other cities, Mumbai, Pune, Kolkata, Delhi, and they are here, and we truly appreciate for them being here and making this platform a true exchange of ideas between professionals of various cities. Friends, we are almost in the end of year 2018, and looking back, I think year 2018 has been a year of caution, consolidation, a lot of JVs we have seen, very few launches from the developers. They have been more focused on exhausting the existing inventories. I think all these are signs of a sector that is maturing. We are getting more organized, more professional. And this is one very aspect that we will be discussing today at the conclave. We have an expert panel who will be talking about what is the key to success for the developers in the current circumstances. As Dr. Batra also mentioned in the AV that we just saw, that South India has fared much better than many other cities across the country. And one of the reasons is the IT sector that has been driving the commercial and the residential sales across the region. Our first panel discussion is on this very topic, that what are the trends of real estate market in this particular region. So some very pertinent topics that we have in this conclave. And in fact, overall, if we see, I think, the last few reforms, policy reforms, RERA, GST, although they have been pain points for all of us, for the entire real estate sector in the short term, but I'm sure everyone agrees that they are good for the sector in the long term. And we are already seeing the boost in the investor confidence from international arena. They are looking at investing and funding co-working spaces, build-to-core projects, affordable housing, warehousing segment, which is, you know, because of the rise in the e-commerce in India. And this has also led to the change in the mindset of developers. Now they are more focused on design and planning of their projects. They are more focused now, they are looking at adopting technology for their projects. And that is why we have chosen, as Kanya just mentioned earlier, the topic of design, integrating design in the project development and adopting prop tech in the real estate. I also,
going a little off topic here, but I would like to mention about a very talked about project of government, not the affordable housing, but the Statue of Unity, which was recently completed in Gujarat, and it was completed in record 33 months. So if there is a will, there is a way. And if government wills, it can complete numerous infrastructure projects across the country, if not in record time, at least in the given project timelines. A wishful thinking, but I think we should always hope for the best. So on that note, while we are talking about strong will, I would like to call Amit Vadwani, a dynamic and a young entrepreneur from Mumbai who leads Sai Estate Consultants. And he is here. He has taken out time from his busy schedule. And in fact, he almost missed his flight to be here. So thank you, Amit, for being here, for your support to Realty Plus. And I would invite him on the stage to share his views. But before that, thank you all very much for being here, being part of the Realty Plus Conclave. And have a great day. Amit, over to you.
Thank you, Sapna. That was very kind. And my dress sense today talks about is very similar to the preparedness of the real estate industry when RERA came in. None of us were prepared the way I am not prepared in a t-shirt and a jeans today. Almost missed my flight, but I'm happy to be here for the lamp lighting and happy to be here a part of the event. So Sapna spoke about solidarity or some strength or some willpower to do certain things. I think the way the industry is now panning out, more than design element, prop tech, approvals, land premiums, what is needed is the will that we will take this industry out of the troubled times. If any one of us, so I always vouch that whenever I get a platform, because I am known to be a self-obsessed guy, to, you know, my picture is right here. If you come to Mumbai, Sugat Baroda, again, my picture is there. I do a TV show which I host. I don't know the kind of job that I do. But Tripti and Annurag sir, they keep telling me that you're still 5 on 10. You still need to keep getting better. But the point here is that the Indian consumer today wants accountability. Bahut aise builders hain jo kehte hain ki ye mera brochure hai. This is my elevation, this is my perspective, but mujhe limelight mein nahi aana hai. I don't want to be in the epicenter of what, you know, what I'm doing. I am not very brand. I have Manish here, who's a very dear friend of mine and also publishes a lot of ads, does about 200 crores of business. Typically, he also says, mujhe limelight mein nahi aana hai. But I think the time is, people want to know the man before the plan. Before they see what you are buying, selling, they want to understand whether you have the capacity to deliver what you are promising. So Amit Vadwani and Sai, you're the big brands, in the sense of other big brands, I'm still a budding young company, can talk about a lot of things, but what if mujhse ho nahi paya? As a consumer, aap kya sochoge ki ye sari cheeze RERA ke website pe bhi dal di, in Maharashtra and Mumbai, Gautam ji is a very, very able administrator who holds all developers together, provides support. To an extent, there is a fear factor also working that we should not really, you know, do certain things which are not, which will not go down well with the regulator. But agar aapse nahi ho paya at the end of the day, if you don't deliver, if your accounts become NPA, so the consumers are thinking in that direction. So when we are communicating with them, we need to tell them more about assurances, about safety of their monies, as to how their payment will be utilized to construct the building, as to how the payment will be utilized to reduce debt, to come up with better structures. Why not? A lot of my young developers who come on our panel from Gujarat, I remember the gentleman from Gujarat, 30-year-old, second generation guy. He's an MBA, he's an engineer. You know, so I am very happy that a lot of second generation developers are coming into their father's businesses after holding a degree. Because there was a time there were developers only coming in because kisi ko kuch kaam nahi milta tha, to wo broker ban jata tha, aur jiske paas kuch kaam nahi tha aur thode paise the, to wo builder ban jata tha. That was the story of India, but which is slowly changing. And I'm quite positive, very bullish, very aggressive, very disruptive when it comes to my consumer needs and wants and desires and rights. If we all start speaking positively, though I do a show on Republic, you know, and I people keep telling me, don't do builder bashing. But ultimately, if you've seen all the 14 episodes, we end on a positive note. If together in this room, we decide whether architects, brokers, marketeers, digital marketeers, ATL, BTL, if everybody says that I will speak positively about Indian real estate, I think that is the first step towards taking the industry out of troubled times. Now, I'll just take one more minute and speak to you about Realty Plus. You know what was the most attractive piece about Realty Plus? The most attractive piece about Realty Plus and Dr. Batra's magazine was they don't sell awards. Am I allowed to say this with media people here? Unse award khareedna nahi padta hai. Agar aap deserve karte hain, to aapko award mil jayega. Aap unko 2 lakh rupaye dene ki koshish kijiye, aapko award nahi milega. Aap char phone kijiye apne kaam ke baare mein batayenge, to maybe if not this year, next year they'll do it. And I am not the owner of Realty Plus. I am a big fan of Dr. Annurag Batra, because the way he works, I feel if I can do even 50% of that, I'll be able to do much better and achieve more in life. Salute to Tripti, who works with two challenging personalities like Amit Vadwani and Annurag Batra. Both are very ex-tempo. We don't tell her, I don't tell her what I'm going to speak. Do we use scripts? We don't use scripts on Republic Television. It is completely ex-tempo. Few of my friends have been on the show, and we do a rapid-fire 22-minute. I hope I'm able to do some magic. And one more thing. If the real estate industry feels that while communicating, I can also entertain the audiences, keep them engaged. Because who wants to see elevations? I was coming from the airport. So many hoardings. All elevations everywhere. Who wants to see elevation? Can fresh air be an amenity? Can oxygen be amenity? Can leaves, etc. be amenities? So, you know, this is maybe I'm digressing from the subject of a welcome speech to what consumers would want to know. But I feel the times have come where a typical IITian, a typical IIM may not be able to do such a good job, but somebody who is like a college dropout like me could come up with such a disruptive company who could end up selling stocks the way we are doing in different cities. So the next 2-3 years, I feel, are quite bullish. Rera, GST, demon, jisko kaam nahi karna hai, uske excuses hai. Ye teeno cheez hai. Yaar, business nahi hai, Rera nahi, Rera aa gaya, GST aa gaya, demonetization aa gaya. ये सब चीजों को आके काफी टाइम हो गया है एंड पीपल हु आर डूइंग वेल इन बैंगलोर चेन्नई वेस्ट बंगाल गुजरात एनसीआर आई वोंट नेम द डेवलपर हैज सोल्ड स्टॉक्स वर्थ 4 बिलियन सो आई मीन इफ यू हैव द कैपेसिटी टू डू बिजनेस टाइम्स आर बुलिश स्टे पॉजिटिव गॉड ब्लेस यू एंड ऑल द वेरी बेस्ट थैंक यू
Thank you very much, Mr. Vadwani, for really spreading the positive cheer and for really making it in spite of you missing your flight. Really, thank you. And thank you, Ms. Srivastava, for the welcome speech as well. I'd also like to take this opportunity to thank our partners for today's event, which is presented by Sai Estate Chembur Private Limited, co-powered by LIC Housing Finance Limited, our co-partners Swarnagraha, Tata Pravesh and Pride Group, our conclave partners Prism RMC and Navmi Builders and Developers, our luxury automobile partner BMW Navneet Motors, our digital transformation partner Intellica, our event associate Sulapuriya Sattva, Sylvan 4QT, Nolte Kitchens and MaxLight, our digital success partner Indusnet Technology, our wellness partner Bio Ayurveda, our print partner Canon Vare, our live streaming partner 24 Frames Digital, our design partner Creative High, our event partner Another Idea, our social media partner Brand Neethi, our PR partner Prachar PR, and our community partners, Exchange for Media and Business World. Could we give a huge round of applause to our partners, ladies and gentlemen?